Hey guys, welcome back to another very interesting video of our channel, Versatile Knowledge. So it's really nice to be back on camera again. I was busy in something else, so I was not able to shoot the videos on our channel. So I'm back again on camera, and today there were some really important tech news and tech updates that I wanted to give you guys. So I'm shooting this video. Let's straight away dive into this video, guys. The first news or update is coming from the brand Realme. The most anticipated mid-range smartphone of the year, the Realme X, is going to be launched in India on July 15th. It has been officially confirmed by Realme themselves that the launch of the Realme X will be happening in India on July 15th at around 12:30 p.m. The device will be packing a full edge-to-edge display, which is a full HD plus display, and with a pop-up camera mechanism, a Snapdragon 710 SoC, and a lot of other exciting features. And already a lot of videos have been posted online about the Realme X. You guys can obviously check out that. And the Realme X Spider-Man Edition, which is actually a special edition with which you'll be getting that red color back case, will also be launching in India on the same date. The second update is again coming from the brand Realme itself. Realme CEO Madhav Sheth has confirmed that the Color OS 6, which is the version of the Android skin which is running on the Realme range of smartphones like the Realme 2, Realme 2 Pro, Realme 3, Realme 3 Pro, and the upcoming Realme X, will be getting an update with the help of which the system-wide dark mode will be enabled on the Realme range of smartphones. So if you are having a Realme smartphone, or if you are planning to buy a Realme X smartphone, then you can enjoy the system-wide dark mode that you will be getting in the future update of the Color OS 6. So guys, the next update is coming from India's number one smartphone brand, Xiaomi. Xiaomi's sub-brand Redmi will be launching the Redmi K20 and the K20 Pro series of smartphones. These two smartphones have already been launched in China, and the Redmi K20 Pro is the flagship grade smartphone, which will be coming in the range of around 25 to 30,000 rupees, and the Redmi K20 will be a mid-ranger or a powerful mid-range smartphone, which will be coming in the range of 18,000 rupees. And the Redmi K20 and the K20 Pro is expected to come to India around the 16th and the 17th of July. So if you guys are planning to buy a new smartphone, I would like to request you guys to wait a few days or just a couple of weeks time, because both the Realme X and the Redmi K20 in the mid-range series will be coming, and the Redmi K20 Pro will be coming in that flagship or the budget flagship range. The Redmi K20 Pro, we all know that it has a flagship Snapdragon 855 SoC. As Manu Kumar Jain has been teasing on Twitter that it is the fastest Android smartphone as per the Antutu benchmark, and also a lot of other reviewers have posted the videos of the Redmi K20 Pro saying that it is faster than any other Android smartphone. So when it comes to India, I think it is going to kill the other phones in the competition, like the OnePlus 7, the Asus Zenfone 6, or the A6Z, which we should be calling right now, and the OnePlus 7 Pro as well, because of the price to performance ratio it is going to offer. So the Redmi K20 and the K20 Pro might come to India in around 16th and 17th of July. So that's the update, guys. So guys, the next update is coming again from the brand Redmi, that Redmi will be launching that Desh Ka smartphone again. From the last couple of years, they have been launching this very entry level smartphone called the A series of smartphone, like the Redmi 4A, Redmi 5A, Redmi 6A, and now the Redmi 7A will be launching in India soon. That is today. When this video goes live, I'm sure that 4th of July would be live, and this Redmi 7A will be launching today, that is the 4th of July. And this smartphone is expected to be having a 18:9 aspect ratio, 5.5 inch HD plus display, guys. And it is a very entry level smartphone, guys. It is not for people who are extensive smartphone users. It will be having the Snapdragon 439 SoC, 13 megapixel rear camera, a normal 5 megapixel front camera, other features which are common for any Xiaomi smartphone. But this is a very low price smartphone, and we are expecting that Xiaomi will be launching the smartphone in India as low as 6999 rupees. So once the Redmi 7A gets launched tomorrow, we can see how good is this smartphone. So guys, the next update is coming from Huawei. So officially, the Huawei and the Google ban, which was going on from the last 1 month, which we saw a lot of a tiff and lot of confusions in the technology industry, has been lifted. I think you guys might be informed about this already, but it is my responsibility to tell you guys about this in depth. So the thing here is, Trump or the US government had put a ban on Huawei range of smartphones to not have any trades between US based companies like Intel, Microsoft, Google, AMD, or other smartphone or other technology companies based out of United States. So this ban went on for a month, and Huawei tried to fight back, and all those things were happening. So Right now, after a month of all those confusions and drama, the Trump government or the US government has officially confirmed that this company Huawei can receive components from US based companies. That means Google has now got the official green signal to give its Android license to Huawei and on a range of smartphones. So the Huawei ban has been successfully lifted. But this doesn't mean that Huawei will not be blacklisted. The government has also revealed that Huawei is still under official US radar or the blacklist. That means US government will be keeping a look at what are the activities that Huawei is doing. If they find something as suspicious, I think they might put a ban on the company again. But as of now, you guys can think of buying Huawei and Honor smartphones. So the next news is coming from again the Xiaomi guys. So Xiaomi has launched their Mi CC9 and CC9E smartphones in China yesterday. So CC9 is basically a smartphone which is a upper mid-range smartphone, and CC9E is a smartphone which is a lower mid-range smartphone. So CC9 has that water drop display and it has a very less chin, and CC9E has that dot notch display and a slightly bigger chin when it compares to the CC9. So CC9 has the Snapdragon 710 and the CC9E has a Snapdragon 665 SoC. Both of the smartphones have triple rear camera setup running on Android 9 Pie, running on MIUI 10, and other features are same. And the most important thing is both of them has that USB Type-C port and also the in-display fingerprint scanner technology. The Mi CC9 smartphone will be coming to India as the Mi A3, or that Android One smartphone that Xiaomi releases every year in the Mi A series. So last year Xiaomi released the Mi A2 with the Snapdragon 660 and Android One, which is actually the Mi 6X. This year Mi 9X or something has not got launched in China, but it is being said by leaks and rumors that Mi CC9 itself will be coming to India as the Mi A3 with that Android One. So this was the update from Xiaomi. The next update is coming from Vivo guys. Vivo has launched the Vivo Z1 Pro, most anticipated smartphone in the Vivo range of smartphones. So Vivo Z1 Pro has that Snapdragon 712, which is an upgraded version to the Snapdragon 710 SoC. It has the triple rear camera setup. It has that in-display camera, or it has that Infinity O display, just like the Samsung Galaxy S10 or the S10e. It has an LCD display, guys. It's not an AMOLED display. It has an LCD display, a USB Type-C port. It has a fast charging and a lot of other features. And this smartphone has been launched in India today, and it will be available via Flipkart from 11th July. So the sale will be starting from 11th July, and the base variant 4GB 64GB is priced at 14,999, 6GB 64GB is priced at 16,999, and 6GB 128GB is priced at 17,999. This smartphone will be directly competing with the likenesses of the Realme X and also the Samsung Galaxy M40, which was launched last week. So this was the update from Vivo. The next update is coming from Samsung Galaxy. So Samsung, the largest smartphone company in the world, will be launching their biggest flagship of the year, the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 this year. And it has been officially confirmed that the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 will be launched on August 7th. The Samsung Unpacked event has been kept at the date of the August 7th this year. And as per the teaser that has been released by Samsung, it is actually confirming that the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 will be having that single Infinity O display with that punch hole camera coming to the center of the smartphone, as per the leaks and rumors that we are seeing from the last couple of months. So this was the update from Samsung. So guys, the final update is coming from Apple themselves. We are receiving Apple leaks and rumors like the iPhone 11R, iPhone 11, and also the iPhone 11 Max, or the largest version of the iPhone 11 range of smartphones. And this time we are receiving a news from a very trusted source saying that Apple will be launching their new range of smartphones, which will be having an in-display fingerprint scanner. It will not be having any Touch ID or Face ID or anything. It will just be having an in-display fingerprint scanner, but this device will be specifically made for Chinese markets. This device will not be available anywhere else in the world, just like US or North America or India or some other countries. It will specifically sell only in China, as per the leaks and rumors. It will be having an in-display fingerprint scanner, and it will not be having a Face ID, as I said earlier, and the rest of the features actually are still unknown, guys. If we get any update about this, we'll be certainly giving you guys the in-depth information and also the first-hand information about this update. We apologize for the fact that we were not able to bring videos from the last 3 days because we were stuck in some other works as well. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you guys might have liked this video. Please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, and if you have still not subscribed to our YouTube channel, you have to hit that subscribe button, as we are your source for all the latest updates, tips, tricks, software, applications, news, products, reviews, and a lot of things in diverse and in detail related related to technology. Thank you for watching, guys.